Do you remember last time when I promised to concentrate more on hardware part and provide you the complete guidance on PCB designing, PCB manufacturing and PCB assembly process? I believe I even had a long hair when I promised. It's been a while and now the wait is over. In this video series, we are gonna walk through PCB designing with Altium design software and PCB manufacturing with one of the best PCB manufacturers in the current industry, PCBWay.com. PCBWay.com offering 10 pieces of 2-layer PCBs at just $5. Get your PCBs ready at PCBWay.com. The link is in the description below. And finally, we will cover the PCB assembly part in my lab. So without wasting time, let's get started. In this project, we are gonna make a recharge hub for 18650 lithium ion batteries. I need this recharge hub for my next projects which are in pipeline. Before jumping into the PCB designing and manufacturing part, let's understand the theory behind the lithium ion batteries. Here I am gonna explain briefly about lithium ion batteries using an animation video from one of my favorite YouTuber Learn Engineering. I'm gonna leave the original video link in the description. If you want to learn more about lithium ion batteries, you can check it out after the video. In a practical cell, the graphite and metal oxide are coated on copper and aluminium foils. The foils act as current collectors here, and the positive and negative taps can be easily taken out from the current collectors. And organic salt of lithium ion acts as electrolyte, and it is coated onto the separator sheet. All these three sheets round onto the cylinder around a central steel core does make the cell more compact as shown here. I brought some teardown videos of lithium ion batteries from fellow YouTubers. I appreciate their work to provide valuable information and knowledge. You can observe the same thing as explained in the animation on the teardown videos. There are some foils and graphite and metal oxide is coated on the foils. If you wanted to charge this battery, we need to connect a power source which has a higher potential difference than battery. Now let's see what happens when you connect the power source across this arrangement. The positive side of the power source will obviously attract and remove electrons from the lithium atoms of metal oxide. These electrons flow through the external circuit as they cannot flow through the electrolyte and reach the graphite layer. In the meantime, the positively charged lithium ions will be attracted towards the negative terminal and will flow through the electrolyte. Lithium ions also reach the graphite layer space and get trapped there. Once all the lithium atoms reach the graphite sheet, the cell is fully charged. Please note that graphite does not have a role in the chemical reaction of the lithium cells. It just acts as a storage medium. In general, a fully charged battery is used to power up any circuit or load. As soon as the power source removed and the load is connected, the lithium ions want to go back to their stable state as a part of the metal oxide. Due to this tendency, the lithium ions move through the electrolyte and electrons by the load. Thus, we get an electrical current through the load. Once all the electrons and lithium ions reach the metal oxide, the battery is fully discharged. If we connect this to the power source again, the battery will get charged again. This process will be repeated. These are the different type of lithium ion batteries I have. The size of the battery is different, but deep inside, all the batteries are working on the same principle. But while charging these batteries, we need to take care of few precautionary measures such as charging current controlling, overcharge and over discharge protection, and the reverse voltage protection. Usually an inbuilt battery management system, which is BMS, is used to take care of all these things. But 18650 do not have any inbuilt BMS. So we should provide one when we are charging it. When I searched for a BMS for lithium ion batteries, I found this tiny PCB with TP4056 on internet. This module is made for charging rechargeable lithium ion batteries using constant current to constant voltage charging method. In addition to safely charging a lithium ion battery, the module also provides necessary precaution required by lithium ion batteries and also includes two indicator LEDs. Red LED indicates charging and blue or green LED indicates charge completed. This module uses a both TP4056 and DW01A lithium ion battery protection IC, which together in combination provide the following protection features. Constant current to constant voltage. Manages the constant current to constant voltage charging of a connected lithium ion battery. Overcharge protection. The module will safely charge your battery to 4.2 volts. 4.2 volts is the healthy maximum voltage level for your battery. Over discharge protection. Keeps your battery from being discharged below 2.4 volts. 2.4 volts is the healthy minimum voltage level for your battery. Over current and short circuit protection. The module will cut off the output from the battery if the discharge rate exceeds 3 ampere or a short circuit condition occurs. Trickle charge. If the voltage level of the connected battery is less than 2.9 volts, the module will use a trickle charge current of 130 milliamperes until the battery reaches 2.9 volts or maximum. After going through all these features, I decided that this module is best for battery management system for 18650 package of lithium ion batteries. This is the simple circuit to charge the 18650 lithium ion batteries. I wanted to make a hub which can charge up to 4 batteries at a time. I thought PCB is the best way to manage these batteries and charge safely and eliminate all messy connections. So this could be the circuit for 4 batteries charging hub. Here I am gonna use one TP4056 module for one 18650 battery. We can also use one TP4056 module to charge more than a single battery by connecting all batteries in parallel. When connecting two cells in a parallel, both cells must be at the same voltage level. Otherwise, if one cell has a lower voltage than the companion cell, the higher voltage cell will discharge into the lower voltage cell in an attempt to bring the two cells to the same voltage, which eventually balance out. But if the voltage of the two cells differ enough, the resulting current through the both cells can be high enough to cause the cells to overheat or worse. When charging two parallel cells connected to this each module, the charging current through each cell will be half of the total charge current, that is, if the each cell has equivalent voltage levels. By keeping in mind these two issues, I decided to use a single TP4056 module for single battery. So in the next video, we will walk through the PCB designing of lithium ion charging hub with Altium and PCB manufacturing by PCBware.com and PCB assembly exclusively in my lab. So that's it for this tutorial. See you soon in the next episode. Bye bye.